Hi, in this video I am going to speak about basic constraints. I have a project already ready on which I have not done anything. I have just created a new project. I'll run this. We'll see this empty view. Here is my view. So this is our empty view. Now I'll just add a button here. I'll add a button at the end. Okay, you notice the button is of some distance from this corner and this corner. I'll run it. But see here, the space between the button and the margin has increased quite a lot. Here we see a small difference, whereas here we see greater distance. This distance will keep varying based on the device. This should not happen. If I say my button has to be fixed to the right end corner, it has to be fixed there. So to do all this, we need constraints. That is what we are going to see today. Okay, so I can add constraints to tell of how much distance the button should be from this end, or and how much height and width the button should be, irrespective of any device that it runs on. To do that, I choose this button, control, click and drag to the super view. Here the super view is the view itself, and here I have so many options. I am going to say the trailing space to the container margin, this space, the trailing space to container margin, I am going to set that. And I can go here is my constraint. I can say some 20. Okay, always remember, when I start adding a constraint, I should give all the constraints so that the button can be properly placed. It is not that I can just tell it has to be of this distance from the end. I should also tell the other features. So I'll also give the top distance. If you want, you can see the error which tells need constraints for Y position, which is demanding the top distance. So I'll go again, I'll do the same thing, control, click and drag to the super view, and it tells vertical spacing to top layout guide. I click this. Okay, and I can just change some constant. I can say I want 20 from top. Okay, so because I've given this distance and this distance will automatically be calculated, because the screen would ideally be of this size, of any size. And when I say this distance need not be mentioned. So that is how it works. I'm running the project, and now you can see whatever distance we see here will be seen in the simulator. So the same distance. Instead of running every time in the simulator, you can also make use of feature given here. Here it will be like this. You can select this and say iPhone 7 and you get all the devices. So this is how it will look in iPhone 4S, and this is how in SE. Please note, in all the devices it is looking same. It is placed in the same distance. So iPhone 7, 7 plus, everything. Now imagine I remove the constraints, and now you see iPhone 7 is, it is of this distance. See what has happened to iPhone 7. It is moved. So this is why the constraints are really necessary. I'll put back the constraints, and see, I put back the constraints. I just did command Z, which is undo, and I got the constraints back, and now all the devices, it is going to be same. So this is the basic constraints. You can also add constraints from here. Instead of click drag, I can say horizontally in container and vertically in container. Horizontally in container means the view will be placed exactly in the middle of the container, which tells horizontally it is in the middle. And I have another option which tells vertically in container, where the view will be vertically placed in the middle, meaning it will be in this area. And here I have height, width, and these are all constraints to the nearest view or the margin. So these are all margins. These are all called margins. To the nearest view, in the sense, imagine there is another button here, and so this is the nearest view for this. That is how it is. And I can keep adding constraints. So this is a very simple basic setup which we can do using constraints. But constraints is really a huge topic, and we'll be covering all that in different videos. Keep watching, keep following for more videos. Thank you.